This is a series that we do here called Broadway at Birdland, where we bring in some of the most brilliant Broadway performers, composers, and cabaret singers in town. And this, I have to tell you, I'm so excited about this particular show. And I'm so glad you all are here to share it with us. Please welcome to the stage the amazing Peter Sacken.
Hey.
My name is Peter Zack, and this is Dan Lipton. Welcome to Birdland and Strings Attached. To my knowledge, this is the first time a cellist has given a solo cabaret show. Thank you. And I'm very excited about it. And the cool part about cabaret is that I get to talk. Some music you listen to, and it's rather like reading a novel. You have to pay attention. You have to remember what's happening. You have to remember the themes. You have to remember how it goes. And then other music, it's like candy, and you just eat it, and you forget it, and it's done. And still other music is like poetry, which is what we're going to hear next is a piece that's like poetry. And the best kind of poetry that I know, the poet doesn't so much describe the emotion that the person's trying to get as he emotes it in the reader. You feel what it is that's being expressed to you. And I think that happens in the next piece. It's called Samba for Susan. It was written by Ricky Ian Gordon for his sister Susan, who passed away last summer.
Cello, not very well. No Rostropovich, not even close. In fact, his playing in timbre, style, and tone is most akin to an adenoidal drone. He plays the cello, and that's okay. He plays on weekends, or when we fought. He doesn't get so unstrung about such things. If he can find time for strangling his strings. Thank you.
you've noticed that I never put my cello down. I never put it down. It's because it's a very personal item to me. I looked for my cello for 2 years. All over, I was in Hong Kong and London, all over the US, looking for an instrument that I could afford and an instrument that meant something to me, something that I could latch onto or maybe that was part of me. And so I looked for a long, long time and I found nothing. And I found one for a moment in London, but I couldn't afford it. It just was too much. So I gave up. I came back to New York, and I'd just given up on the idea of a cello for the time being. And I went to see my luthier, my cello doctor, over at the Carnegie Building, Brice Dupin. And Brice is a very charming man. He speaks like this. He has a wonderful accent. He makes you feel very important when you go in. And we were talking, and he said, you know, I have this cello in. Do you want to try it? So I tried it, and 2 years and 5 minutes later, I'd found my cello. And it was rather like finding a part of yourself that you didn't know was missing, because it speaks for me. It is the sound that you hear. And I imagine it's like having a child. And a child, and a good segue, is the subject of our next piece. It's by Tom Kitt, and it's called The First Sonogram, and it's a musicalization of his feelings and his reactions of seeing the sonogram of his child for the first time. Tour in France with an orchestra, and three of us decided we didn't want to go home. It was summer, we bought Eurail passes, and we decided to play on the street for money. It was going to be a great time, and we did. We had our passes, we went, you know, France, Milan, Florence, Vienna, wherever we could go, and it was wonderful. And what was interesting to us was that the people that gave us the most money, the people that stopped and listened the most, were Americans. That's the ones, they really dug it. And what was more interesting was that when we stopped playing and they came up and started speaking in broken German or French, and discovered that we, in fact, were from America, they were incredulous, they were upset, they couldn't believe it. Some of them wanted their money back. It's true. And when we ask them why, what is it? And they say, we've come here to hear Europeans play classical music. You know, we feel like we're being gypped. They have the gravitas in Europe. They have that, it's part of their soul, it's part of what they eat and drink. And it's simply not true. But we Americans believe it, and if you doubt me, I invite you to go up to Lincoln Center afterwards, look at the posters, and to this day, almost all the soloists are European, almost all the conductors are European. We really believe this, not to mention the composers. Now, I can't do anything about the soloists or conductors, but I can do something about the composers. I'm trying my best. And so I'm very happy, yes. Thank you. So I'm very happy to be able to play for you two more pieces by American composers. Thank you.
and every night, wherever you may chance to be, close your lovely eyes and dream with me.
Peter Sacken, ladies and gentlemen.